Today I would like to show you a simple way to paint a miniature. I'm going to start with shadows and paint everything blue. Working from shadows to highlights is the way I prefer to paint, but it can also depend on what kind of paint you are using. The more transparent it is, the more layers you will need to paint to reach the same opacity. You could also start with mid-tones instead and paint your shadows later. On the palette you can see a selection of both warm and cold colors. Colder shadows and warmer highlights will give your composition a more natural look. And painting cold and warm colors next to each other will increase contrast in your work. Before moving on to mid-tones, I paint a few smaller details first. At this stage, it's much easier to fix the paint that will get everywhere. I didn't give enough time for the blue paint to dry, so I had to work a little bit harder while painting the eyes. Once I'm happy with opacity, I move on to mid-tones. The idea here is to paint less and less with each subsequent layer. So I don't cover everything with teal, but try to leave some of the darker blue in the shadows unpainted. Notice how I hold the painting handle in my left hand. I often tilt it to make the painting surface more parallel to the brush. In this case, I work less with just the brush and more with both hands. I don't strain my right hand as much, and this helps to apply paint very lightly. This approach will help you to be more precise when you paint a very small area. Making paint more transparent will allow a previous layer to show through, which we will utilize later to make more colors. Thank you. a thin orange with water and apply it over blue, which gives me a nice brown color. The more water you add, the darker your brown will be. And for the areas I want to highlight, I will be adding more and more orange. You could also add some white or yellow, but keep in mind, adding white or black will reduce saturation. I want to have a reddish brown for the bow and arrow, so I mix a little bit of red violet with orange. Same as before, I want to be able to see the blue color, so now the surface I cover with paint is very small. Even less so for the bow. To create some texture, I leave a lot of space in between. Now I'm moving on to painting warmer highlights. So I will be adding more orange, yellow, and white to following layers. When it comes to painting metal, I like to use gray as a base. For the highlights, I add more orange and white, and more blue and black for the areas in the shadow. Now that I paint highlights for the face, I cover even less of an area with paint. This will allow the previous color to show through and will create an even stronger contrast. I decided to keep the blue color for the robe, and I add just a little bit of red violet to paint a slightly warmer highlight. Thank you. To paint wear and tear, I mix a bit of orange to the color I chose for the robe. All that is left now is a few final highlights. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you next time.